Thank you. Can we, anybody who's curious...
I was going to ask, can you talk a bit about your process?
Yeah, so in this set, I mean, it's a mixture between compositions and live triggering of sounds, but also a lot of it is generated in real time by my brain states. So depending if I'm like in attentive, like focused brain state or meditative brain state, the synthesizers or some sounds are changing in the composition. I think the second movement was also triggered by the blinks of my eyes, and also so it's it was this kind of mixture between composing triggering sounds and also like improvising with my brain states.
There was a moment when it seemed like the only input was from the scanner.
Yes.
And you managed to get at some point total silence. Is it because of the threshold or something? Or
yes, exactly.
Or did you achieve enlightenment and
managed to... He left us for a while.
You're actually right. It has to do with the threshold. So depending how... basically the software used is like if it goes beyond a certain threshold,
mm-hmm.
there's like certain parameters that are set in a certain way that if a threshold goes up, it sends a trigger and also like a constant parameter as well. So yeah, it's quite dynamic in a sense. So you can like get total silence, but also you can do like constant sounds.
Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Do you guys have questions, maybe?
I'm so impressed how it was mesmerizing by times, and I'm wondering, like, in terms of frequency, so basically it's like recording the brain waves, and is the feedback, like, if you record some brain frequency of brain waves in your brain activity, does it translate it, like, straightforward into the same frequency feedback? Or?
No, this is mostly, I would like to think of it as a MIDI controller.
Yeah.
But instead of playing it with the fingers or, you know, it's the sensory input is the brain state. So it's basically a very small amplifier that amplifies the variations of voltage in the school, and that translates it into via an algorithm into like attention or meditation. So it's not directly the sounds from my brain. That would be, it's not a sonification per se. It's more like
electrical activity.
Exactly. It's more like it translates the electrical activity to do an event.
Yeah.
And not the electrical activity into sound directly.
So basically you have like already the samples provided by the because this is an industrial device, right?
Excuse me?
This is an industrial device, like the EEG sets that you're...
The neurosky thing, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, you design the like what...
The mapping of the parameters, so it's quite open, so I have like different synthesizers.
Yeah.
In which different parameters within the synthesizer are mapped through different thresholds on like, depending on what level. So that it gives you a more like gestural performance of like...
Okay.
So your brainwave is like a control voltage.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like a joystick.
But the sound you use is you choose it in advance.
Yeah, it's like more the aesthetics of the sound is like my own.
Yeah.
And this instrument you design it yourself or?
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
No. This is a commercial like prosumer kind of a device. It's not it's a Bluetooth. Yeah, I think they market it more like for...
they have a few games.
Yeah, they have like games and that
right.
kind of stuff.
Okay.
Like
that.
Yeah. Yeah.
They think called like neurotherapy or neurofeedback therapy.
Mm.
Feedback
therapy.
Sounds good.
Neurofeedback. Yeah.
That's what you just got.
Therapy, like white noise therapy and so on.
Yeah, it's like this like the idea behind it is like if you can control your brain to like do certain gestures, you can like, you know... mitigate anxiety or depression or whatever. No?
So what are you thinking about during the performance?
Well, nothing specifically. I've tried to not cagarla. How do you say it? Like, not fuck up.
Don't fuck up. you are trying to think positive.
Yeah, exactly. and like at this point, like the contrast is like when it sounds like super abrasive sounds, I'm trying to focus in a meditative state, so kind of like calm. But the sound is very harsh, so it's kind of like this contrast.
It's just feedback, right?
Yeah. It's kind of like, yeah. It was take out the the negative vibes.
And did you try to play then without with headphones that you don't hear the sound, that it's not interfere you?
Mm. I've never done that actually. That would be
with like earplugs, yeah.
Yeah, that
because
would be
if
actually
you hear it, then it's this internal feedback. So yeah, maybe if you, it would be easier to meditate on.
Yeah. that would be.
Maybe it would become silence then, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Or maybe another music.
Huh?
Or maybe just another music.
Yeah, exactly.
Radio as well.
But yeah, thank you for coming.
Yeah, thank you.
Super interesting.
Thank you, Robert, for inviting me. Really, yeah.